When you lose a child, there's something that happens inside of you that is not something I could describe to anyone unless you have experienced it, and I don't wish that my worst enemy.
When we lost Joshua, we were faced with a system that was not set up to learn. We were faced with an organization that was very fearful.
A lot of people accept it. They don't want to dig into it, or they're not being told the truth. And they accept it and they say, this was God's plan, this was God's will. But when it's needless, that is the biggest dagger.
I kind of thought it was a one-off for us, just a horrible chain of events. But then we started to see that these were actually medical errors. These were mistakes. And we still thought, okay, well, a bunch of horrible mistakes were made, but maybe it just happened to us. Maybe it happens once every 10 years or something.
I first saw it in the hospital where Yogi Raj died, but it didn't take long at all to realize that it was happening in hospitals, not just in the United States. It was happening in hospitals around the world. And for me, the dynamic around not just that we need to be transparent, we need to teach transparency.
We have spent 12 years now basically bringing awareness, educating the public, and doing everything that we can to allow families not to go through the same tragedies that we went through of losing Niall at 15. So it's very important to us that we participate as much as possible and to do everything that we can to pass this information on to others.
How can we take these tragedies and try to make something positive out of them? We have a voice to say, hey, we don't like what you're doing, and we want to help you do it better.
There are so many facets of it that we have to be working at simultaneously in order to get, you know, positive healthcare outcomes for everyone. And it's going to take all of us being involved and having a seat at that table and being part of that discussion, being out in our communities, being part of organizations that are actually out there on the forefronts fighting to ensure that we have change.
I want patients to be confident and to trust your gut and to trust your instinct, advocate for themselves, advocate for their loved ones, and then for those who can, advocate for their community and beyond.
Everyone has the ability to fix this problem and prevent harm and death. And so we bring the joy of our son, Niall. We bring the music, we educate the public, and we do it in a way that is memorable so that the next time somebody is going into the hospital, they're gonna know.
And we've seen changes, and we've seen the adoption of some of the new technologies, and it's just been wonderful to see how this is catching on. So we're doing our part.
When we went to the state legislature, they were very surprised to hear our side of the story, the patients that have died from being opioid naive. And so they moved it all forward with no negative votes. And the biggest thing about it is they're gonna start doing some research to find out more about it and the exact cause.
When we come here, it's refreshing to hear other stories, but it's also very sad because you know they are going through the same heartache and the battles, and they are not quitting. But we know we are a family. So you're hearing what they're doing in, you know, Utah or et cetera, you know you're not alone and you're not crazy. We are right. We did bury our loved ones and it was needless.
I have to have a reason to put my head in my pillow at night and go to sleep. And so if I can just do that one single thing each day on behalf of my son's name and help maybe somebody else not grieve the way our family did, and I constantly do, then I've done something. And Josh did not die for nothing. That's why it's important to me.